Welcome to Lectern Line. Here we're starting a new set of videos on Gauss's Law and the electric flux to get us a better understanding. So we're going to talk a little bit more about the details of all that. But we're starting with the concept, what is electric flux? And actually, it's kind of difficult to imagine what it is. So the best way to define it is as follows. Let's say that we have a loop of area A, just a simple loop like this, and the area that is A. And we place that loop within an electric field such that the plane of the loop is perpendicular to the field. So here's the loop, here's the field, the electric field is perpendicular to the plane of the loop. Then we can say that the electric flux through the loop is defined as the product of the magnitude of the electric field and the area of the loop. So it's actually the product of two things. You multiply the strength or the magnitude of the electric field times the area of the loop. That product is the flux through the loop. So the important thing also is that we talk about flux through a loop. Flux by itself doesn't really mean much, but if we go through a loop like a conductor or wire, then there's a lot of meaning to it. So that's the concept of flux. So we can graphically represent it as follows. So let's say that we take the loop here and we turn it 90 degrees. So now we're looking at the loop edge on. And now we have an electric field present. And we can draw an electric field by drawing the electric field lines. And those are kind of synonymous to the flux, or at least proportional to the flux. The stronger the field, the more lines that we draw. So you can kind of graphically imagine the more lines you see, the greater amount of flux that you have through the loop. Also, if you make the loop small, then not a lot of electric field lines will go through the loop, so there's not as much flux through the loop. If you make the loop bigger, then of course more electric field lines will go through the loop, and you have more flux. So really the amount of flux depends upon the strength of the electric field and the size of the loop. It'd be small or large. The amount of flux through the loop, of course, will depend to that. It'll be proportional to that area. So we can say that we can graphically represent it such that the electric flux is proportional to the number of electric field lines passing through the loop. And that's probably the best way to think about it. What's also important is, what happens if the electric field doesn't go through the loop perpendicular to the loop? So we have to consider, if the electric field is not perpendicular to the plane of the loop, then the amount of electric flux, and notice we use the Greek letter phi and a little subscript e for electric flux, it'll be the dot product of the electric field and the area vector. Now, how can an area have a vector? Well, an area can have a vector when you take the normal to the plane. So here we have drawn a loop, and it doesn't have to be a round loop. It can be a square loop. And so here, this vector pointing straight out from the loop, from the area, this vector is perpendicular to the plane. So here's the end vector, perpendicular to the plane. And now if the electric field comes in at a different angle relative to the normal, we can express that by the dot product. It'll be the magnitude, or not the magnitude, but the electric field times the area, a dot product, which is simply equal to the magnitude of the field times the area of the loop times the cosine of the angle between them. So here you can see that if theta represents the angle between the perpendicular normal vector and the direction of the electric field, then it's simply the size of the magnitude of the field times the size of the loop, the area of the loop, times the cosine of the angle between them. So simply, we can write it always like this. And of course, if the angle between them is 0 degrees, the cosine of 0 is 1, that simply drops out, and you come back to the original equation right here. A quick example, let's say that we have an area of a loop that's 5 square meters. The magnitude of the electric field is 200 newtons per coulomb, and let's say the angle between the normal and the field is 60 degrees, then the electric flux will simply be the product of all those, and that ends up being 500 newton meters squared per coulomb. So you can see that the units for flux, or electric flux, is newton meters squared per coulomb. It's newtons per coulomb, the units for electric field, and meters squared, the units for area. And hopefully, that kind of straightens out your understanding about what electric flux is.